You love it.
Some of you may be asking the question of, yes, you're telling us not to fear. You're telling us that God commands us not to fear. You're even saying that fear is without perfect love. You have given us the evidence that fear is not a good thing. But how am I to physically, spiritually, mentally walk out of this fear? Well, dearly beloved, I'm glad you asked. Because the only way to get rid of our fears at that moment is to do only one thing, and that is to face up to it, to acknowledge it, and not just live with it as though now it's a part of your existence, a part of your life, a part of something that you have accepted. So the first thing we need to do is recognize it. And once we recognize it, then we begin to walk toward it. Amen? You know, the Word of God tells us when Satan comes to us as a roaring lion, what are we to do? We are to stand still and firm in our faith. Amen? We're called to do that. But also, we are called to walk forward, to pursue that which we know that God desires for us in our life. The Word of God says in Psalms 23, yea, though I walk, amen? When we talk about walk, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. So, dearly beloved, we have to do what? We have to continue to walk. And many times, the reason why we don't get through our fear is because we look at it in amazement and we are incapable then to walk forward. We stand and we allow it to overwhelm us, to run over us, because we are so overwhelmed and fearful of what is now taking place in our lives. And so what do? We look for a conclusive answer. And that conclusive answer always will be, we or will come out on the short end. That's why people, beloved, react in such uncharacteristic ways as a believer. Because it seems like once you get around certain Christians, that they don't act and respond like Christians ought to act. It's because, beloved, because of fear. They make choices in their life because of fear. But I want to say to you, when you are facing up, when you are walking through, glory be to the living God, that is when you begin to see the hand of the Lord working in your life. You don't see the hands of the Lord working in your life when you are simply standing and being amazed at what has just happened to you, what has just befallen you. You are very fearful and very scared. And when a person is scared, they do one or two things. They either stand there afraid, petrified, or they begin to run in the opposite direction. Well, the Lord does not call us to run in the opposite direction. And this psalm tells us very clearly, yea, though I walk, where is he walking? Through, glory be to God. So as I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, the psalm writer, which is David, is saying to you and I am walking through the valley of the shadow of death. I'm not going there to reside. I'm not going there to take residence in the shadow of death, in that place in my life, but I am walking through. When Saul had made up his mind that he was going to annihilate David, was going to kill him, he knew that God had made a promise to him. David did. And David knew that somehow, even when his own son Absalom was trying to kill him, that he would make it through. Why? Because he trusted the Lord. He was walking through the valley of the shadow of death. He wasn't standing in amazement trying to figure out, well, why are these people against me? Why my own son is against me? Why the past ruler wants me dead? No, not the past ruler, but the ruler today. Why do the king want me dead? David could have stood in amazement trying to figure that out. But he refused to do that, and he continued to walk and to live, glory be to the living God, and walk through the valley of the shadow of death. And he says, in the midst of that shadow, I will fear no evil. I will fear no evil. Beloved, because he knew who his God was and is. Beloved, we need to know who our God is. Amen? And we will walk through this fear. But if you don't walk through it today, believe me, you will face it tomorrow and the next day and the next day and the next day until your mind is made up to fear no evil. Beloved, fear is torment, as the word of God says in 1 John 4:18. Fear is torment. It will torment you for the rest of your days if you're not willing to face up to it, to recognize it, and then to begin to walk through it. Amen? So, dearly beloved, you are called to walk through your fears and believe that your God will always be by your side, not necessarily meet you on the other side. He is there with you in the midst of your walk. Beloved, begin walking today out of the fear that you have in Jesus' name.